In this video, we're going to understand one of the most important concepts of Java, that is called abstraction. What is abstraction? Abstraction is the process of hiding certain detail and showing only essential information to the user. In other words, the user will have the information on what the object does instead of how it does. We are simply hiding the logic, the business logic from the user, because we don't want user to have access to the business logic. So you can hide that business logic with the help of abstraction. I'll give you one example in order to understand it better. Let's say you are getting an incoming call, right? And we know that clicking on this green sign, I can connect to the call. And by clicking on this red sign, I can disconnect the call. But what is the logic behind it? As a user, I am not aware of it. What is the logic behind this, that by clicking on green sign, I can connect, and by clicking on red sign, I can disconnect? This concept is called abstraction. Now let's understand how to achieve it. So when I'm saying the business logic will be hidden, that means we're going to create methods without body. So methods will be created, but there will be no business logic or body inside it. We can achieve abstraction with either abstract classes or interfaces. We're going to understand the concept of abstract class and interface in this video, but little later. I'll say this is one of the most important interview questions. They mostly ask you that, you know, what is difference in abstract classes or interfaces? So we're going to understand that also in detail in the later half of this video. First, let's get started and create abstract classes. I'll click on new, go to class. Write down the name of the class. Let's say phone. I'm going to choose abstract here. So click on abstract. And here, click on finish. So this is how you create abstract class. What are the major things you must understand and remember about abstract classes? First of all, we cannot create object of abstract class. Number two, we can create constructor of abstract class. These are some of the important interview questions. They will definitely ask you whether we can create object of abstract class. No, we cannot. Whether we can create constructor of abstract class. Yes, we can. And then in abstract class, you can have 0 to 100% abstraction. Meaning of this is you can create methods without body, or you can create methods with body also in abstract class. It's not mandatory that you have to create methods without body only in it. So you can achieve 0 to 100% of abstractions. It's your choice. You want to create methods with body or you want to create method without body. So both are acceptable in abstract class. So here, let's create a method now without body. Guys, understand this is the logic behind abstraction, that you will be just creating a method without body. You are hiding the implementation logic of the method. How we can achieve it? Let's see that. So you will simply use the keyword called abstract first. So abstract, return type, name of the method. So let's say for phone, I'm writing the name of the method is connect call. And that's it. You need not to write the body of the method. It's called abstract method. This is abstract method, method without body. So in this case, I'm not writing logic of the method. So I'm not writing the logic behind connecting a call. I'm hiding that information. So this is called abstract. Now, second point, as I've told you, you cannot create object of this abstract class. Let's try doing it. So I'm writing phone, a assign new. Look at this, it's giving me error. And if I put my cursor over here, cannot instantiate the type phone. That means you cannot instantiate this particular class or create object of this class. So this is not possible. So I'm just gonna make it comment. Next, I can create constructor of abstract class also. So in order to create it, I can simply write public phone and creating the body of it. So this is how you can create even the constructor. I'm just adding something in the body of the constructor. So system.out.println. Here I want to write abstract class constructor. So yes, we can create constructor of abstract class, but we cannot create object of the abstract class. Next point is you can achieve 0 to 100% of abstraction. That means you can create methods without body, as well as you can create methods with body also. So let's say public details. This out control space. And here you can type. So method with body. So this is something I'm writing. So we can create both without body as well as with body. Now you might be like, okay, we have created some methods, but how to call them? Because as we understand, in order to call any method, if it is not static, in order to call any method, I need to create this object, but somehow I cannot create object of this class. Let's understand this, how to call these methods now. So I'm creating new class now. So go to new, let's make one more class and naming it as Samsung. This is the class I'm creating, Samsung. I will include public static void main, the main method, and click on finish. Now here, if I try to make object of this class, because I want to call methods of this class, let's try doing it here also. So I'll write name of the class, sign new, again name of the class. Not possible, again giving me error. You cannot instantiate this type of the type phone. So okay, I'm gonna remove this line. Now how to call it? In order to call the methods which are there in my abstract class, I need to extend it. That means I need to make this class as parent. So I'll write extends name of the class. Guys, as soon as you will write name of your abstract class over here, you will see red line beneath name of your child class. So if you put your cursor over here, it is saying add unimplemented method or make it also abstract. Means whatsoever methods are there in phone must be implemented here. This is also one of the points you need to understand about abstract class. If any of the abstract class is inherited, that means if you're making any abstract class as parent, all the methods inside that abstract class must be implemented here, as well as their bodies also must be created over here. So let me show you with the example. So I'll put my cursor, I click on add unimplemented methods. And see, abstract method will be automatically coming over here. Now this method's body, it is mandatory for me to create body of this method over here. Now here you can write down the logic. It's not in the abstract class, it's gonna be in child class, and it is mandatory for child class to create body of abstract method. So here, I can write down system.out.println Samsung logic connect call. In order to call, so you need to create object of this class, not parent class but child class. But let's see how we do it. So I'll say new Samsung. And here also I will write Samsung be assigned. Let's see what we can see over here. So B dot, look at this. Connect call, yes. Details, yes. It is coming from phone. So you can call method like this. You need to create simply object of the child class. This is how you can call. Let's execute it and see how it works. Look at the results. First of all, it is showing you abstract class constructor. I'll come to this point later. Second, it is showing you method with body. That means it is calling details. And in details, this is the body I've written. So if you have to check it, see, method with body. So details is called. But what about this first line here? Let me show you. But what about this line over here? Abstract class constructor. Guys, you remember we have created constructor also in abstract class. How to call constructor of abstract class? Simply by creating object of your child class. When you create object of the child class, abstract class constructor will be called first. Parent class constructor will be called first. And then the method is called. In order to call this method also, you will be simply writing B dot second method. So you can call this method by creating object of child class. So in simple words, if I want to call abstract class methods, I can call it by creating child class object, because abstract class object cannot be created. This is very much important to remember. First point, abstract class, you can achieve 0 to 100% of abstraction. Second, you cannot create object of abstract class. Third, you can create constructor of the abstract class. If I want to call any method of the abstract class, I need to inherit that. And then whenever I'll create child class object, constructor plus method of that abstract class or parent class will be called. So this is called abstraction. Now let's understand concept of interfaces. What is interface? As I've told you, there are two ways to implement abstraction. One is by creating abstract class. Second is by creating interfaces. Interfaces, first of all, in interface, you must have 100% abstraction. That means you cannot create any method with body in interface. There should be all the methods without body in interface. Second, you cannot create static methods. So static methods cannot be created. Third point is common in both abstract class and interfaces. That is, we cannot create object. Both abstract class and interface. What is interface? As I've told you, interfaces are created to achieve abstraction. That means you will be creating methods without body to hide the business logic. And other classes can implement it. Let's understand meaning of it. So I'm going to show you one example over here. Let's take a real-time example. Let's say there is an interface called WebDriver. Now this interface will have all the abstract methods for browsers. Now we can understand all browsers, guys, work same, right? Google Chrome, Mozilla Firefox, Microsoft Edge, all the browsers have same functionality, but they might have different business logic. So in interface, we will be having all the common methods. So common methods like, you know, browsers, we can open the browser, we can close the browser, we can navigate. There might be different add-ons in the browser. So these are some common guidelines for any browser, which is declared as an abstract methods in an interface called WebDriver. Guys, this is a real-time example. If you have heard Selenium WebDriver, WebDriver is an interface in it, right? WebDriver is an interface which have all the common abstract methods to launch the browser, close the browser, or whatever actions you want to perform on a browser. Now, This interface, like in abstract class must be inherited by some other class if you want to call the methods. Same way, interface must be implemented by the other class. So the keyword we're going to use in this case is implements. In case of abstract class, we use the keyword called extends with other class. So let's say this class is there, which is Google Chrome. Google Chrome will implement interface called WebDriver. Here I have Firefox. So Firefox will also implement. Interface called WebDriver. So this is how you can use methods of interface into other classes. Difference in abstract class and interfaces. Abstract class will have 0 to 100% of abstraction. That means you can either have complete methods or you can have incomplete methods. Doesn't matter. You have choice for both of them. Whereas in case of interfaces, we must have 100% abstraction. That means whichever method you are creating in interface must be abstract method without any body. Static methods cannot be created in it. You cannot create static methods. We cannot create object of both abstract class and interface. So you cannot create objects. So you cannot instantiate the interfaces also. If I want to use methods of abstract class into other class, I need to inherit. I will be using extends keyword. Whereas if I want to use methods of interface, I need to use keyword called implements. With implements, you can use all methods of interface. This is mandatory to use all methods of interface if you are implementing it. Let's say Google Chrome is implementing interface WebDriver, then it is mandatory for Google Chrome to use all methods of this interface. You cannot skip any of the method. We have to use all methods. So this is how we can use interface. Let's understand this with the help of practical example. So here, I'm going to create an interface. So you will click on, right-click on project, go to new. And here, instead of choosing class, we will choose interface. So click on interface. I'm going to name it as, let's say, WebDriver. And click on finish. So this is my interface, which must have all the abstract methods. So here, I can write down public void. Let's say open browser. Second could be public void close browser. Third could be public void navigate browser. So I've created these three methods, which are abstract. So I don't have any body inside it. Guys, we do it in order to maintain the confidentiality, hide the business logic. Second, it might be possible that all the classes which are implementing it might have the different logic. So they can use the guidelines from here that all the browsers should open, close, or navigate, but their logic might be different. So they will be implementing it just to know the guidelines that, okay, these should be the methods. And now body will be according to their business logic or their requirements. So let's see how we do it. So I'm going to create one more class here. So let's say I'm going to name this class as Google Chrome. And I can have the main method in it. Click on finish. So this is my normal class I have created. Now I want to use methods which are declared in my interface WebDriver, which are declared in the interface called WebDriver. So here I need to use the keyword implements instead of extends if you're using abstract class, if you want to implement methods of abstract class, you can use extents. But if you want to use methods of interface, you will use implements. So implements, name of the interface, in this case it is WebDriver. See, as soon as I've written this, red line will show beneath name of the class. Put your cursor over there, it is showing you add unimplemented method. As I've told you, in both abstract class as well as interface, it is mandatory to implement all the abstract methods of interface or abstract class. So we must implement all the methods. So when I click on this, whichever method I have created in my interface will come over here with the annotation called @override. This @override is called annotation. So with this annotation, override, and here you will have all the methods with body. So here you can create your own logic. You can create body according to the requirement of your class or your according to the requirement of the class. So in this, let's say body should be system.out.println. Open Google Chrome. So same here, I can write close Google Chrome. So here I'll write So here also I can create a body. Navigate Google Chrome. So I've created body. Now I've created logic according to my requirements. So this is how you can implement all the methods of interface. Let's say I don't want to implement this one. So I'm going to remove it. See, again, the red line will come over here. So this is mandatory to implement all abstract methods of interface. Same logic is there for abstract class also. It is mandatory to implement and create body of abstract methods coming from either abstract class or interfaces. So I'll do that and see. Again, it is coming over here. So let me just quickly create body of it. Let's try to make object of this interface. So I'll write WebDriver. Deassign new WebDriver. See, it's giving me error. If you put your cursor over here, cannot instantiate the type WebDriver. As I've told you, interface and abstract classes both cannot have object. They cannot create object. Now let's see whether interface can have constructor or not. So public WebDriver. Look at this. Interfaces cannot have constructor. So this is also one of the difference between abstract class and interfaces. Abstract class can have constructor, whereas interfaces cannot have constructors inside it. So this is also one of the difference. Now, one more thing is there. You can create variables also in it. It's not like an interface, you can just create methods, but you can declare and assign values to variables also. So here I can write int a, let's say assign 10. So I can do that. I can declare and assign, but if I just want to declare, I cannot just declare it. I need to assign value also. So initialize final field a at declaration. So initialize this field at declarations. We must initialize, that means assign value to it. Now in order to access this, let's say now I want to access A. In order to access this, let's go here. We will be creating object of This class, same ways as abstract class. So this class, which is implementing the interface, its object needs to be created. So I'll write Google Chrome G assign new Google Chrome. Now let's access it. So for that, I will be writing system.out.println name of the reference dot a. So this is the variable you are calling. So this you can call like this also. Now let's say I will be creating one method in Google Chrome also. So it is Google Chrome's own defined method, not coming from interface. So it's Google Chrome's own method. So let's say public void add-ons. So system.out.println. Many extensions are inbuilt. So this add-ons is Google Chrome's own method, and these three methods are coming from interface. Now, if I will write G dot, I can see add-ons, I can see navigate browser, I can see open browser, and I can see close browser. Means all the methods which are coming from WebDriver, that is interface, as well as method of Google Chrome class, who is implementing the interface. So I can see all methods, all four methods with this. But let's say if I want to see only methods which are coming from interface, in that case, I can use interface name for the reference. So here I can write name of the interface, any reference variable, and it is pointing to the object of Google Chrome. That means now with the help of G dot, you can access only methods which are coming from WebDriver. You will not see method coming from Google Chrome class. That means you're not gonna see methods of this class, its own methods. So yes, interface or abstract class, they cannot create objects, but you can create reference of the interface, which is pointing to the object of implementing class. Well, lastly, one more point you need to understand is, in interface, whichsoever variable you are declaring and assigning value to it is by default static. That means you need not to write static keyword in front of it. It is by default static. If I want to call this variable in this class, I do have two choices. I can write this, as well as I can write name of the interface dot here, variable name. I can write name of the interface dot variable name. As you know, only static variables are something which you can call with the name of class name or interface name. So this is how you can call it. So few things which we understood till now is, number one, abstraction is the process of hiding certain details and showing only essential information to the user. In other words, the user will have the information on what the object does instead of how it does, because the part which is explaining how, you're hiding that part. So this is abstraction. Now, abstraction can be achieved in two ways. One, by creating abstract class. Second, by creating interfaces. When you create abstract class, you can achieve 0 to 100% of abstraction. That means one abstract class can have method with body as well as without body. Second, you can create constructor of abstract class. Third, you cannot create object of the abstract class. So these are few important points we should keep in mind. If I want to call methods of the abstract class, I need to inherit it with the keyword called extends. Once the abstract class is inherited, it is mandatory for the child class to implement all abstract method of abstract class, I mean the parent class. Second way of implementing abstraction is through interfaces. It will achieve 100% abstraction. Static methods cannot be created in it. That means you cannot create methods with body, and you cannot create methods with body. That is what 100% abstraction is. So it must be without body. We cannot create object of abstract class. And there is also one more point. You cannot create constructor. Of interface. This is also one of the difference. If we want to use methods of interface, we need to use the keyword called implements. And you are supposed to implement all the methods in the class which is calling it. So this is mandatory. You cannot skip even a single method. It is same in both of the interfaces and abstract class. So guys, this is one of the most important topics, and very frequently it is being asked in interviews that what is difference between abstract class and interfaces. I hope you understood it. That's all for this video. Thanks for now.